för mig att kalla fram pastor Ebere till att ge oss budskapet från Herren idag.
Halleluja.
Halleluja.
Praise the Lord.
Prisa Herren.
First of all, I would like to thank Apostle Liliana.
Först och främst vill jag tacka Apostle Liliana
for giving me this privilege to minister this morning.
För att få det privilegiet att betjäna den här morgonen.
I didn't know I could minister. I could have the opportunity to minister in this.
Jag hade ingen aning om att jag skulle få möjlighet att predika i den här konferensen.
I'm grateful that she gave me this time.
Men jag är tacksam för att hon har gett mig den här möjligheten.
And secondly, I also want to appreciate all of them that came from Holland, Reverend Vanessa, Reverend Ludo.
Och jag vill också bara visa min uppskattning på att de har kommit ända från Holland.
I would like to call Olive. Please, can you come?
Och jag önskar Olive, kan du komma?
Please come.
Och.
You see, on Wednesday night.
I onsdags kväll.
He has been very healthy.
Så var han frisk.
There wasn't any problem with him.
Inga problem med honom.
Nothing at all.
Inget alls.
So on Wednesday night we went to visit the family in Upplands Väsby.
Och i onsdags så var vi och hälsade på en familj i Upplands Väsby.
And then we were driving home.
Och vi körde hem.
Late at night around 11 p.m.
Sent runt 11 på kvällen.
And then all of a sudden.
Och helt plötsligt.
He started vomiting.
Började han kräkas.
Heavily.
Mycket.
Vomiting heavily.
Starkt.
The whole car was messed up.
Hela bilen blev förstörd.
And we didn't know what was wrong.
Och vi förstod inte vad som var fel.
We tried to clean him up and
försökte
change his clothes.
Tvätta honom ren och byta kläder.
We got home.
Kom hem.
Around 2 at night.
Och runt 2 på natten.
And he slept.
Somnade han.
Around 4 again.
Och på 4 igen.
From sleep he started vomiting.
När han sov så började han kräkas.
So he vomited out of sleep till in real life.
Så han vaknade upp kräkande.
So we knew something was actually wrong.
Och vi förstod att det måste vara något fel nu.
And we didn't know what.
Vi visste inte vad.
So we tried to, you know, just help him, give him Alvedon.
Vi hjälpte honom, vi gav honom Alvedon och lite så.
So he was better.
Han kände sig bättre sen på dagen.
And then on Thursday night again.
Men på torsdag kvällen igen.
He was sleeping.
Sov han.
And then around 1 a.m. at night.
Och runt 1 på natten.
He woke up and started crying, my stomach.
Så vaknade han och grät, min mage.
This time it wasn't vomiting.
Nu var det inte kräkningar längre.
And he was just turning up and down from the top of the bed to the down to
cry. Han vred sig omkring i sängen och kunde inte vara stilla.
He was just restless.
Han var helt rastlös.
And because he couldn't sleep, we couldn't sleep as well.
Eftersom inte han kunde sova, kunde inte vi heller sova.
We kept awake all through the night.
Så det var vaknat för oss.
In the morning,
och på morgonen,
we went to the closest barnavård central.
Så gick vi till barnavårdscentralen, a child health care center.
He was just, they saw how he was just, you know, crying.
Och de såg hur han grät.
They took blood tests, urine tests.
De tog blodprover och urinprover.
And then the doctor said, oh, it's possible it's appendicitis.
Och han sa, och doktor sa förmodligen så är det blindtarmen.
And they couldn't handle it there.
Och de kunde inte hantera det där.
So
förstås.
They sent us to Astrid Lindgren
sjukhus. Så de skickade oss till Astrid Lindgrens sjukhus, hospital.
At Solna.
I Solna.
So this was Friday now.
Och det här var på fredag nu då.
So there at Solna.
Och där i Solna.
They took another blood test.
Så tog de ytterligare blodprover.
Urinprover. They said they didn't see anything.
Och sa de ser ingenting.
They did ultrasound.
De gjorde ultraljud.
And they said it's not appendicitis.
Och sa det här är inte blindtarmen.
They didn't see anything wrong.
Såg inget som var fel.
But yet he was crying.
Men ändå så grät han.
And they said just go home and give him water.
Och de sa åk hem, ge honom vatten, låt honom.
Still he was in pain.
Men han hade fortfarande ont.
Until yesterday.
Tills igår.
He was just trying to run around with other kids.
Han försökte springa runt med andra barn.
But then sometimes in between he would come to me and cry. His stomach.
Så kom han till mig och grät, min mage. dagar.
And then when Apostle Liliana made the altar call.
Och igår när Apostle Liliana sa att någonting komma fram för förbön.
I went and brought him.
Så gick jag ut och hämtade honom.
So she prayed for him.
Och hon bad för honom.
All of a sudden, his face was somehow sad.
Hans ansiktsuttryck hade varit lite ledsam tidigare, inte riktigt glatt sådär.
All of a sudden, he brightened up.
Men helt plötsligt så bara ljusnade han i ansiktet.
I believe he was here.
Och jag tror han blev botad.
And then he was better.
Och han blev bättre.
We went back.
Vi åkte hem.
But before the service was over.
Innan vi gick tillbaka så innan mötet var slut.
He started crying. Så började
han säga igen, jag har ont i magen.
So I brought him to her.
Så jag tog med honom till henne.
She prayed again for her.
Bad igen för honom.
And then we went home.
Och sen åkte vi hem.
But throughout the night.
Genom hela natten.
In fact, throughout the whole of yesterday.
Egentligen hela gårdagen.
He couldn't eat.
Så kunde han inte äta.
He was still crying.
Och han grät fortfarande.
In fact, this morning, while we tried to make him to eat some food,
and
then he started vomiting again. But we just have to come.
Anyway.
But something miraculous happened. You know, all this while, when you pray for him and ask him, you know, we try to make him say by faith, I'm here. He will say, no, I'm not.
Vi försöker få barnet att när vi har bett för dem att de ska säga i tro att de är botade, men han sa nej, jag är inte botad.
We want to force him to say I am here.
Och vi ville nästan tvinga honom att säga att du är botad.
He will say no, I'm not yet. He's still telling me.
Nej, jag är ju inte botad. Det gör ju ont fortfarande.
So that while we were coming.
Så när vi kom hit nu.
Just this afternoon.
Den här eftermiddagen.
In the car.
Så i bilen.
All of a sudden.
Så sa
he jumped up.
Så hoppa han till.
I said, yes, God has hit me.
Ja, Gud har hittat mig.
God has hit me.
Gud har hittat mig.
I looked at him and I knew he wasn't joking because I have tried to make him to say it before.
Jag hade försökt få honom att säga det här.
He say it.
Men han kunde inte det.
So now he's saying it, I know it's real.
Men nu när han säger det så vet jag att det är
verkligen. I believe he's here.
Yeah.
So I want to give God in praise. Also, he made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself poured our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high.
Sedan Gud i forna tider många gånger och på många sätt hade talat till fäderna genom profeterna, har han nu i den sista tiden talat till oss genom sin son. Honom har han insatt till att ärva allting, och genom honom har han också skapat världen. Sonen utstrålar Guds härlighet och uppenbarar hans väsen och uppehåller allt genom sitt mäktiga ord. Och sedan han nu utfört en rening från synderna sitter han nu på majestätets högra sida i höjden.
I'll just pick a phrase from verse 3.
Jag tar en fras ifrån vers 3.
And upholding all things by the word of his power.
Och uppehåller allt genom sitt mäktiga ord.
Upholding all things by the word of his power.
Uppehåller allt genom sitt mäktiga ord.
The scripture didn't say he upholds some things.
Det står inte att han uppehåller en del saker.
He didn't say he upholds many things.
Eller att han uppehåller mycket.
He said he upholds all things.
Utan att han uppehåller allting.
By the word of his power.
Genom hans mäktiga ord.
That is simply saying.
Det säger helt enkelt.
God sustains the universe.
Gud uppehåller hela universum.
By his word.
Med sitt ord.
The sun and the moon.
Solen och månen.
And the stars. And the planets are kept in place by the word of God. The seas and the mountains and the trees are kept in place by the word. Your life is kept in place by the word. Now, if God can keep the sun and the stars for millions of years without falling,
utan att ramla ner,
God can keep your life,
så kan Gud bevara ditt liv,
without failing,
utan att misslyckas,
by his word,
genom sitt ord.
Now if you read in John chapter 1,
om du läser Johannes kapitel 1,
from verse 1,
från vers 1,
the scripture says,
så säger Bibeln,
that in the beginning was the word,
att i begynnelse var ordet,
and the word was with God,
och ordet var hos Gud,
and the word was God,
och ordet var Gud,
and by him he created all things,
och genom honom har allt blivit skapat,
and there is nothing that was made,
och det finns inget som är
skapat, that was not made by him,
som inte är skapat av honom.
So you see that God created the whole world by his word.
Så Gud skapade hela världen med sitt ord.
Now you can understand it better.
Du kan förstå det bättre.
That if the whole world was created by the word,
att om hela världen skapades genom ett,
then it is possible to sustain the whole world by the word.
Så är det också möjligt att uppehålla hela världen.
Because if the word can create,
för om ordet kan skapa,
the word can as well sustain.
Så kan ordet också uppehålla.
Now you may be asking.
Nu kanske du frågar.
How does the word sustain?
Hur kan ordet uppehålla?
What is the power in the word?
Vad är det för kraft i ordet?
Jesus Christ told his disciples.
Jesus Kristus sa till sina
lärjungar. John 6:63.
Johannes 6:63.
The words that I speak to you.
De ord jag talar till er.
They are spirit.
De är ande.
And they are life.
De är liv.
The words that I speak to you.
De ord som jag talar till
er. They are spirit.
De är ande.
And they are life.
De är liv.
So simply saying,
jag säger helt enkelt,
that is a spirit.
Att det finns en ande.
The spirit is the power.
En ande som är makten.
In the word.
I ordet.
So when God releases his word,
så när Gud läser,
the spirit goes behind it.
Så kommer
to manifest it.
För att manifestera.
To fulfill it.
För att uppfylla det.
And that is why the sun is still in place.
Det är därför som solen fortfarande är på sin plats.
God has given the word.
För Gud har gett ordet.
And the spirit has kept the word.
Och anden har bevarat ordet.
To fulfill what the word has said.
För att uppfylla det som ordet sa.
This is still the same way that God works in our lives.
Det är fortfarande på samma sätt som Gud verkar.
In Romans 10:17.
I Romarbrevet 10:17.
The scripture
says. Så säger skriften.
That faith comes by hearing.
Att tro kommer genom hörande.
And hearing by the word of God.
Och hörande från Guds ord.
So, and also in Hebrews chapter 11.
Och i Hebreerbrevet 11.
You cannot please God except by faith.
Så står det att du kan inte behaga Gud.
So when you please God by your faith.
Så för att behaga Gud med din tro.
God will release his power.
Så kommer Gud att förlösa
then
sin kraft.
How does the faith come?
Men hur kommer tron?
By the word.
Jo, genom ordet.
So everything still goes down to the word.
Så allting kommer tillbaka till ordet.
Everything starts and ends on the word?
Vad är egentligen ordet?
What is the word?
Vad är ordet?
The word is simply a sound.
För ordet är ett ljud.
The word is simply a sound.
Det är helt enkelt ett ljud.
Like I'm speaking to you now.
Jag pratar med dig nu.
I'm speaking words to you.
Så det är min röst.
Let you hear the sound of the word.
Du hör ljudet från min röst.
You don't see the word.
Du ser inte ordet.
Let you hear the sound.
Men du hör ljudet.
I came here to tell you this morning that there is a sound from heaven that can change anything in your life, be it spiritual or physical, be it financial or marital, in any area of life, in the society, in the nations of the world, there is just a sound that can change everything and manifest the glory of God. I will give you instances from the scriptures. In Genesis chapter 1, the scripture says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was everywhere. And God came to the scene, and God said, let there be light, and there was light. So in essence, God released the sound. When God released the sound, darkness gave way, and light came. In Numbers 23, verse 21, when the children of Israel were on their way to the promised land, they came to a particular country. They wanted to pass through. And the king said, no, you cannot pass through here. And Balak, that's the king, went and hired a prophet. And the prophet was Balaam. He said, Balaam, come and curse these people. Come and curse these children of
Israel.
And then when Balaam came to the scene, he looked at them from the mountain. He wanted to release a curse. But all of a sudden, the curse turned into a blessing. If you read in Numbers 23:21, he said, I cannot curse them because the shout of a king is with them. The shout of a king is with
Israel.
And because the shout of a king is with them, there is no cause that can survive in their lives. What is the shout of a king? That is the sound of heaven. When the sound of heaven is in your life, no cause can grow in your life. Nothing any man tries to do against you that can survive. Let's go further down.
Låt oss gå vidare.
In Joshua chapter 6.
I Joshua kapitel 6.
Still in attempt to break into the promised land.
Fortfarande försöka komma in i det förlovade landet.
And then they came to Jericho. The scripture said that Jericho was fortified with walls.
Det står att Jericho hade tjocka murar.
It's not written in the Bible.
Det står inte i Bibeln.
That the wall, the size of the walls.
Hur breda de var.
But I've heard scholars say.
Jag har hört teologer säga.
That the walls of Jericho.
Att Jerichos murar.
It's so wide.
Var så breda.
So that two cars.
Att man kunde köra.
Can run comfortably on the wall.
Bekvämt kunde köra på muren.
But what happened?
Men vad hände?
God told Joshua,
you saw Joshua
and your men
and
the children of Israel march around the city of Jericho,
att de skulle marschera runt Jericho
once a day,
en gång per dag,
for 6 days.
Under 6 dagar.
And then on the seventh day,
på sjunde dagen,
march around again,
skulle marschera runt
7 times.
7 gånger.
And on the seventh time,
på sjunde gången,
let the priest blow the trumpet.
Så skulle prästerna blåsa.
And at the sound of the prophet, of the trumpet,
let
the people give a shout.
Så skulle folket ropa.
The walls will come down.
Då skulle murarna falla.
Now, physically speaking,
fysiskt talat,
there is no way a sound can bring a wall down.
Så kan inte ljud få murar att falla.
But in obedience to the word. Remember, I told you everything starts from the word and ends on the word. So when they obeyed the word and marched around the way God has instructed. Then on the seventh time, they gave a sound. When they gave a sound, the walls came crumbling down. No matter how high it was, no matter how wide the walls was, the walls came crumbling down. Just by a sound. Just by a sound. And that was the sound of heaven. If you can release that sound of heaven today, no matter the walls that have surrounded you, no matter the walls that has made you not to go forward, no matter the deepness of the walls that has stopped you from going into your own promised land, they will come crumbling down. In the name of Jesus. Let's go down a bit. In 1 Kings chapter 18. Because there was apostasy in the land of Israel.
They had backslid.
They had backslid from following God. And then the prophet Elijah came to the scene. Elijah said, according to the word of the Lord, before whom he stands, there will be no rain for 3.5 years, and there was no rain, just by a word, just by a sound, the heavens was blocked. There was no rain in the land. Cattle were dying. There was no food to eat. And then after 3.5 years, he came again to the sea. And he said, I hear the sound of an abundance of rain. The sound of an abundance of rain. As at the time Elijah was making this prophetic utterance, as at the time he was releasing this prophetic sound, there was still famine in the land. There was still drought in the land. And there was no cloud. Nobody could see what Elijah was seeing. Nobody could hear what Elijah was hearing. But yet Elijah kept on declaring, I hear the sound of an abundance. And all of a sudden, the scripture says, the skies became black and became cloudy, and there was a heavy rain. I came again to announce to you this morning that I hear that same sound of an abundance of rain. I hear the sound of glory coming to your life, coming in this nation, coming all over the world, in the name of Jesus. Believe it, say yes.
Yes.
Let's go further down. In Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel said, God took me in the spirit and brought me into a valley. And in the valley was dry bones. And he said the bones was very dry. They are so dry that no man could think they could ever live. And God said to him, can these bones live again? And he said, God, only you know. I don't think these bones can live again. But you are God. If you want them to live, they can live. But if you don't want them to live, they will remain dry. And God said to the prophet Ezekiel, prophesy to these bones. Say to these bones, you shall live again. Say to these bones, you shall live again. And that was the sound from heaven. I believe that Ezekiel closed his eyes so that he will not see the nature and the state of the bones. So that he will not be discovered by the sight. For scripture says, we do not move by sight, but we move by faith. So I believe Ezekiel closed his eyes and began to prophesy and said to the bones, these dry bones, hear ye the word of the Lord, you shall live again. For the Lord shall cause bread to come upon you, and you shall live again. And the scripture says, suddenly there was a sound, there was a noise. baptized the man from heaven. And the bones began to join themselves, bone to bone. Bones began to join themselves. And when the bones joined themselves together, he said, I look at them. They were like a living army. But yet there was no breath in them. There was no life in them. And he turned to God again. God said, prophesy again. I tell you, when he prophesied the first time, it may not look as if something is happening. But God is working behind the scene. Prophesied the second time. Ezekiel began to prophesy the second time. And began to prophesy. He said he spoke to the east wind, from the south and from the east. He came to bring breath on these bones. Breath on these bones. Breath on these bones. And they began to come. The scripture says, the bones became, the bones became a living army. The bones became a living army. And God spoke to Ezekiel and said, these bones are the children of Israel. I tell you, as we are gathered here today, maybe your life is like the bones. Maybe your life is dry as the bones. It does not matter what the bones look like. It does not matter what your life looks like. What matters is that the sound is released from heaven. If you can release the sound from heaven, the bones shall live again. The dry bones shall live again. The dry bones shall live again. In the name of Jesus. Let's go all the way to the New Testament. And Jesus Christ came to the scene. Remember where we started. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. And by Him He created all things. And nothing that was made without the Word. So when the Word Himself became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father. In John chapter 11, verse 36, Jesus came to the graveyard where a young man has died 4 days ago. The scripture says that the body of Lazarus was already stinking. The body was already stinking. He had been kept in the grave. They have forgotten about him. They were just crying. They have started to mourn and cry. Their beloved brother is already dead. They have buried him. They have closed the chapter. They have finished his case. And Jesus Christ came to the scene. Jesus Christ said to Mary, he said, didn't I say to you, if you believe, you will see the glory. If you believe, you will see the glory. And he said, take me to the place where you have buried him. And when he came to the place, the scripture says, Jesus Christ cried with a loud voice. He cried with a loud voice. Get ready to shout. He said, he cried with a loud voice. He said, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus, come forth. And the scripture says, he that was dead came forth from the grave. He that was dead came forth from the grave. That is the glory. That is the glory. If you believe, you will see the glory of the Lord. Shout glory. Let's move down a bit. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, from verse 1, the scripture says, and when the days of Pentecost was fully come, when the days of Pentecost was fully come, there came a sound from heaven, like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the whole place where they were. A sound from heaven, like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the place where they were. And tongues of fire was upon them. And they started to speak with other tongues. I tell you, the sound from heaven is coming here tonight. The sound from heaven is coming here tonight. In the name of Jesus. Let's go down a bit. All through the scriptures.
Fortsätter med skriften.
The Bible lets us know that the whole world is sustained by the word. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16, the scripture says, the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with a shout. The Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God. If God has a trumpet, what is that trumpet for? To release a sound. The scripture says, when that trumpet sounds, those that are dead in Christ will rise first, and we that are still alive will be caught up to meet Jesus in the sky. From the beginning of scripture, from the beginning of creation of the world, the whole world was created by the word. Until the day that this world will end up, until the day that rapture will take place, it is the word of God, it is the sound of God that will take up the world, that will rapture us. It is the sound of God that will rapture us. I want to ask you, if God can create the whole world by his word, if God can sustain the sun by his word, if God can rapture your body by his sound, if the dead in Christ can resurrect by the sound, if those that are dead in the grave will resurrect by the sound, what is that problem that you are facing? What is your life that the sound of God cannot sustain? What is your life that the sound of God cannot sustain? There is a song that says, if he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my brother that he could carry you. If he can carry the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my sister, he can carry you by his sound, by the sound of God, by the sound from heaven. He can carry you, he can sustain you, he can carry you. I came to release this sound to you this morning, that the sound of God may come to your life, that the shout of the king may remain in your life, that every wall of Jericho may come crumbling, that everything that is dead in your life may come alive again, in the name of Jesus. Now, if the sound from heaven can be characterized by ordinary sound, then scientists will turn God into a robot.
Då kommer de att få honom att bli som en robot.
Yes, because they will go into the laboratory.
För då skulle de gå in i labbet
and manufacture the sound.
Okay. På något sätt manipulerar det här ljudet.
And then when there is an issue,
så när det är något som händer,
they will just press a button,
så trycker de på en knapp,
and then the sound will go off,
och då kommer det här ljudet,
and then there will be miracles,
och så kommer miraklet,
and then God will be turned into a robot,
och då blir Gud som en robot
that can be controlled by a machine,
som en maskin kan kontrollera.
That the sound from heaven is not any sound that you can find here on earth. There is a frequency that is in heaven. So it's only you, by your faith, that can connect to that frequency. It does not matter if you are educated or not. It does not matter if you are a doctor or not, or whether you are a scientist or not. By your faith, you can connect to that frequency and begin to see the sound of heaven released in your life. I want to read the scripture to us, and then we begin to pray. 2 Kings 6.
Kapitel 6.
Second Kings.
Andra Kung.
Chapter 6.
6.
Hallelujah. Second Kings chapter 6 from verse 24.
Andra Kungaboken 6 från vers 24.
It's a long verse, but I'll try to read it as fast as I can.
Ska försöka läsa så fort jag kan.
So we understand what is happening.
Så att vi förstår sammanhanget.
And it came to pass after this, you don't need to interpret, sorry, fast. And it came to pass after this that Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, gathered all his hosts and went up and besieged Samaria. And there was a great famine in Samaria. And behold, they besieged it until an ass head was sold for 4 score pieces of silver, and the 4th part of a cup of dove's down for 5 pieces of silver. And as the king of Israel was passing by upon the wall, there cried a woman unto him, saying, "Help, my lord, O king." And he said, "If the Lord do not help thee, when shall I help thee? Out of the pump floor or out of the wine press?" And the king said unto her, "What aileth thee?" And she answered, "This woman said unto me, Give thy son that we may eat him today, and we will eat my son tomorrow. So we boiled my son and did eat him. And I said unto her on the next day, Give thy son that we may eat him. And she had hid her son. And it came to pass when the king heard the words of the woman, that he rent his clothes and he passed by upon the wall. And the people looked, and behold, he had sackcloth within upon his flesh. Then he said, God do so and more also to me, if the head of Elisha the son of Shaphat shall stand on him this day." Now there was a siege.
Det var alltså belägring här.
In the city of Samaria.
I Samaria stad.
And because of the siege,
på grund av belägringen,
there was famine.
Så var det hungersnöd.
The scripture says none went out and none came in.
Det betyder ingen kunde gå ut och ingen.
There was no exchange of goods.
Det fanns inget utbyte.
There was no commerce.
Fanns ingen handel.
There was no business.
Ingen företag.
So there was no food in the country.
Det fanns ingen mat.
The economy was down.
Ekonomin var nere.
And things were very bad.
Och mycket var dåligt.
To the point
till den grad
that women
att kvinnor
began to eat their own children. You can imagine the scenario. You can imagine the state that women will begin to eat their own children. Even the scripture says, can a woman forget her child? But here, not only that the woman forgets her child, the woman starts to eat her own child just to survive. And we can identify this in our societies today. Because of the siege of the enemy in our society today, we see so many unthinkable things in our society. We see, you hear things in the news that when you hear, when you hear it in the news, your ears will tingle. Just like when you hear that a woman can boil her own child, your ears will tingle. Because of the siege of the enemy. Because of the siege of the enemy. There is divorce in our society. There is perversion of sex in our society. There is killing and robbery in our society. There is every kind of evil in our society. Because of the siege of the enemy. Because of the siege of the enemy. And some of us are making the same mistake that the woman made. You see, the woman cried to the king.
Kvinnan kom till kungen.
And the king said,
kungen sa,
if God cannot help you,
Gud inte kan hjälpa dig,
where can I find help for you?
Kan jag hitta
the solution is not in my hands.
Inte
I tell you, the solution to the problems in our society is not in the hands of the politicians. It's not in the hands of the government. It's not in the hands of the ruling people. God has given the solution to the church. And you are the church. You are the church. I am the church. And look at what the king says. The king says, I am going to the prophet. I am going to prophet Elisha. And if he doesn't do anything today, I am going to take off his head. And let's continue in verse 7. Sorry, chapter 7. 2 Kings chapter 7. And verse 1. Then Elisha said, hear ye the word of the Lord. Elisha did not say to the king, go and call a conference. He didn't say to the king, go and gather an army. He didn't say to the king, go and buy ammunition. He said, hear ye the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord. Remember where we started. Everything is sustained by the word. Even the country is sustained by the word. Society is sustained by the word. Army is sustained by the word. The government is sustained by the word. Elisha said, hear ye the word of the Lord. Tomorrow, by this time tomorrow, the siege will be over. Seed will be broken. There will be no more famine in the land. I am to give you the same word today. Tomorrow, the seed will be over. No more famine in the land. No more problem in the land. In the name of Jesus. Verse 3. 2 Kings chapter 7. From verse 3. And there were four lepers. Four leprous men at the entering in of the gate. And they said one to another, why sit we here until we die? If we say, we will enter into the city, then the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. And if we sit still here, we die also. Now therefore, Syrians. If they save us alive, we shall live. And if they kill us, we shall but die. And they rose up in the twilight to go unto the camp of the Syrians. And when they were come to the uttermost part of the camp of Syria, behold, there was no man there. For the Lord had made the host of the Syrians to hear a noise of chariots. A noise is simply a sound. And that is not just an ordinary sound. It is the sound of heaven. It is the sound of God. He said he made the host of Syrians to hear a noise of chariots and the noise of horses, even the noise of great hosts. And they said one to another, Lord, the king of Israel had hired against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of the Egyptians to come upon us. Wherefore they arose and fled in the twilight and left their tents and their horses and their asses, even the camp as it was, and fled for their life. And when these lepers came to the uttermost part of the camp, they went into one tent and did eat and drink and carried thence silver and gold and raiment and went and hid it and came again and entered into another tent and carried thence also and went and hid it. And they said one to another, we do not well. This day is a good tidings. This day is a day of good tidings. And we hold our peace. If we tarry till the morning light, some mischief will come upon us. Now therefore come, that we may go and tell the king's household. So they came and called the porter of the city And they told them, saying, we came to the camp of the Syrians, and behold, there was no man.
There,
neither voice of man, but horse tied, and asses tied, and the tents of day. And he called the porters and told it to the king's house within. And king arose in the night. I want to skip, so we save more time. Let me hop to verse 17. And the king appointed the Lord on whose hand he leaned to have the charge of the gate.
Den officer som kungen brukar stödja sig på hade han satt att hålla ordning i stadsporten.
Let's go back to 16.
Låt oss gå tillbaka till 16.
And the people went out and spoiled the tents of the Syrians.
Då drog folket ut
och spoilade. So a measure of fine flour was sold for a shekel.
Köpas ett fint mjöl.
And two measures of barley
för en sikel.
For a shekel.
Och två sikel.
According to the word of the Lord.
Som Herren.
According to the word of the Lord. What was the word of the Lord? He said, tomorrow the seed will be broken. I want to give you 3 points about the Son of God. And then we begin to pray. Number one, the Son of God is not an ordinary sound. There is a frequency of the sound of God. And the frequency of the sound of God is the frequency of faith. The frequency of faith. Remember, when the prophetic sound came forth, nothing happened. There wasn't much. The seed was still there. Everything remained the same. There was nothing that had changed. And the people thought, oh, it's just like that. There were four lepers at the gate. And I hope you know what leprosy is. Leprosy will chop off your fingers and your toes. Leprosy was a deadly disease in those days. And if you are leprous, you will be quarantined. You are not allowed to mingle with people in the city. And that was why they were cast out to stay outside the city. At the gate.
But
these four lepers tuned into the frequency of faith. They tuned into that prophetic word. They tuned into the sound of heaven. I want to tell you, if God can use four lepers,
you
are overqualified for God to use you. We are more than enough for God to use us. If God can use four lepers to change a city, if God can use four lepers to bring down the sea, we are so many for God to use us. And these four lepers tuned into the prophetic word. And the scripture said they began to move. Syrians had made the seed. They were not afraid that the Syrians could kill them. The scripture said they began to move. They began to move. And when they started moving, heaven started moving. This is the point I want to let you know. When you begin to move, God will begin to move. When you rise, God will rise. When you stand, God will stand. So as they are moving, I believe that their feet were not making so much noise. Because of God, the leprosy had chopped off their feet. So they couldn't make much noise with their feet. But no matter how little noise they were able to make, God amplified the noise. And the Syrians were hearing a loud noise. The scripture says, God amplified the noise. And the Syrians hear the sound of an abundance of army. The Syrians were hearing the sound of great army. And they started fleeing. Point number two. When the sound of glory comes, it is not just for your life. It is for the nation as well. The seed that has held the nation captive will be broken. Because of these four lepers, because of the sound of the heavens, because of the sound of the glory of God, the seed was broken. The seed was was broken. The siege was broken. Point number three. It does not matter what situation that has disqualified you. It does not matter what situation that you are facing that people have cast you out. Just like the vapors, they were cast out of the city. They were not allowed to mix up with the people. It does not matter what people have said about you. They have people have said about you. You are not qualified. You are not educated. Or maybe you are sick. Or maybe you are suffering from one problem or the other. Therefore, you don't fit here. And they are cast out to stay at the gate. When the glory comes, when the sound of the heavens comes, when the sound of glory comes, everything that has disqualified you will not matter again. Irrespective of the leprosy, when the siege was broken, when the glory was released, when the sound of God was released, the Bible says the four lepers, they walked straight past the gates into the city, past the city into the king's house. They were not stopped. Nobody stopped them. Glory has come. Because the sound of glory has come. Today, the sound of glory is coming to your life. The sound of glory is coming. Whatever that has disqualified you is not matter again. Whatever that people have said about you, anything that people have used to disqualify you, you will break through. Wherever you have failed before, you will begin to succeed. Whatever that has seen difficult before, we begin to be easy. In the name of Jesus, we will begin to release that sound from heaven. Get ready to shout. Get ready to shout. To release that sound. The siege has been broken.
Beläggningen brutits.
The first siege that is broken.
Beläggningen som är bruten.
Is a spiritual siege.
Är en andlig beläggning.
The scripture says.
Skriften säger.
That the God of this world.
Att Gud över den här världen.
Has blinded the eyes of many.
Har förblindat många människors
ögon. That they will not see.
Att de inte ser.
This gospel of the glory.
Härlighetens evangelium
Jesus Christ.
Från Jesus Kristus.
That siege is broken this morning.
Beläggningen är bruten denna morgon.
I don't know if you are here this morning. If you are here this morning.
Om du är här den här morgonen.
You are not born again.
Och du är inte född på nytt.
You are not born again. You are not born again.
Du är inte född på nytt.
You want to say, Lord Jesus.
Du vill säga, Herre Jesus.
I want to receive you.
Jag vill ta emot dig.
I want to receive you.
Jag vill ta emot dig.
I want to give you this opportunity.
Jag vill ge den här möjligheten.
I want to give you this opportunity.
Jag vill ge den här möjligheten att göra Jesus Kristus till din Herre och frälsare.
Is there anyone?
Är det någon här?
Halleluja. Halleluja. Second siege.
Den andra belägringen.
That is broken.
Som är bruten.
He says that the God of this age
has tidens Gud
blinded your eyes,
har förblindat,
that you will not see the glory, that you will not see this gospel of the glory,
så att du inte ser det här,
that you will not see this glory of God.
Att du inte ser Guds härlighet.
Everything,
allt,
everything that has been a barrier,
som har varit en barriär,
that has been a veil,
som har varit en
that has been
a
siege, that has prevented you
to see
the glory of God. in your life is broken this morning, I want to invite you here to the front so we can pray together. So we can pray together. Is there anyone here? You have been longing to see the glory of God in your life.
You have been longing to see
the glory of God in your life.
And
it's as if something is stopping it. It's as if there is a siege.
There
is a veil that prevents you from seeing that glory.
Som har hindrat dig från